Hello everyone and welcome to the forest. I am Ben, I'm a German forest scientist. You may not know me because normally I'm speaking German, but for this video I will give it a try in English. I'm not quite sure how good you might understand me, but my English is not very good, as you may have noticed. But if I don't practice, I won't get any better, so let's give it a try. Yeah, I am a master of science in forest science, and a very fascinating topic. Forest science examines everything in the forest and tries to discover new knowledge for the understanding of forest ecosystems. Very important today because we have many problems with the forest, so more science would probably help to solve this matter. But now to our video. You may have probably came from Felix Imler's video about the fire starting trick nobody knows. If not, see the link below, and there's also a link to the German version of this video if you are shocked hearing me trying to talk in English, and so you can watch the German version version as well. Felix asked me if I could provide some background information on the combustibility of beech bark, and I hope I can do so. But let's start with the well-known birch bark first, as an example. Many bushcrafters and survivalists already know birch bark as a fire starter. Without a doubt, she's one of the best you can find in nature. But maybe you didn't know which substance make the bark burn so well. This substance is called betulin, after the scientific name of the birch, Betula, and looks like this. The molecule consists only of 30 carbon, 50 hydrogen and 2 oxygen atoms, which is big but not very complicated. And it's cheap and easily made if you are a tree, and you can make it in great numbers too, because it contains only air and water as main ingredients, if you would say so. Molecules like betulin are also called pentacyclic triterpenes. There are many different ones, all of which are formed by plants. You can probably make them in the lab too, but why would you do that? The plant does it for free. So Felix was absolutely right in his assumption that the birch cannot be the only tree that produces a substance like betulin. And even betulin itself can be found in many different trees or bushes, but nowhere can you find as much as in the birch. So the birch is the only tree with this white color of the bark. The white color reflects the sunlight and prevents sunburn. Yes, trees can get sunburn too. And very important for a so-called pioneer tree like the birch, which often grows on clear cuts and on clear cuts where it can be very much sun. Also, betulin has an antibiotic and antiviral effect, which protects the birch from diseases except fungal-based infections. But betulin can also be used by us humans, for example, to treat wounds. This knowledge could also be useful in a survival situation. You can easily make an ointment from birch bark and extract yourself. Take some fresh bark and put it in oil. This must now sit in a dark place for 1 or 2 months. Then mix the oil with 10 drops of liquid wax or some resin from a conifer and let cool. Very easy to make. But beware, this recipe is intended for survival situation only. If possible, always go see a doctor. Or buy a professional made product like Episalvan, if it's available in your country. Because the homemade ointment is not sterile and may contain germs and bacteria, which however is very unlikely. But the most useful, betulin burns like hell, even when it's red. But you may know this. After Felix had told me that beech bark also burns wonderfully, I first went into the forest and thought for a long time about how that could be, and why has no one ever heard of this before, even in science? Can Felix not tell the difference between birch and beech? Ah, just joking, of course he can. He is even very good in tree identification. And after a few hours of thinking and reading my very smart book, I came up with this. The flammability of betulin is nothing special and occurs with all tree terpenes. After all hydrocarbons are flammable. The next step would be to examine other barks for high concentrations of tree terpenes and see if they are also flammable. Felix deals with this in his current video from today. I will deliver the possible ingredients that ensure the flammability. The beech has a kind of poison with which it protects its nuts and its young branches from predators. This poison is known as phagein, called after the scientific name of the beech, Phagus. Since the bark of the young twigs is particularly thin and sensitive, a lot of phagein has to be used here. This also gives us an explanation why only the thin bark of very young twigs is combustible. Phagein looks like this, almost like ammonia. Phagein is much more flammable than betulin and can even explode as a gas. In case you're wondering why beech bark doesn't burn even better than birch bark, very little phagein is stored in it. The birch, on the other hand, stores a lot of betulin, so you could say size matters. But there's a problem. Above 2.9 degrees Celsius, it is a gas. How then can it be present in beech bark? And that's why we can only use the young peeling bark of certain branches. Older bark no longer has phagein, as it has evaporated. But young bark still has some phagein, which is dissolved in water and therefore does not evaporate immediately. So there's only a short period of time that we can find combustible bark on a branch, but since there are so many beeches with so many branches, it doesn't matter much. Well, Felix has tested many other barks for flammability. In his current video, he shows us which burns and how to get the outermost layer, which burns particularly well. If you also want to look for combustible bark in your forest, here I have put together a few tips on which bark could be particularly suitable. Look for thin and smooth barks, even if there aren't any particularly combustible materials inside, it is still paper thin and will burn like paper. Plants from the rose group, such as cherries or almonds, are known for the many oils in their bark. They will burn. You may need quite a lot of bark to start a fire. Trees from which very little bark can be collected or the extraction of the bark is difficult are therefore not suitable. Trees with thick non-combustible bark also have thin bark on their branches. This can burn. Besides birch, there are another well-known tree that burns very well, eucalyptus. But be careful, eucalyptus burns so well, you could accidentally set the whole forest on fire. One last piece of information. If you press the oil from the nuts of the beech, it can also be ignited and used for oil lamps, for example. I hope my English was tolerable and you were able to learn something new. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.